Hi, this is Dr. John Shim, and today I'm going to talk about a very important topic, and that's the use of stem cells. Very common question that comes to my office. Doc, do you use stem cells? Well, let's explore that. What exactly is a stem cell? Well, basically, they're unspecialized cells in your body that through division can differentiate into various tissues. In other words, a stem cell can become bone, muscle, teeth, and so forth. Scientists are trying to understand how to trigger these cells into differentiating into specific cell types. For example, if you can use these cells for a bad heart, can we trigger the stem cells to produce new, healthy heart muscle cells to repair the damaged one? The controversy can be about where we actually get the stem cells. Embryonic cells have been researched, but very controversial, so we'll not discuss that. Really, we're going to focus on adult stem cells. The two main sources are your own red bone marrow and also from your adipose tissue or fat layers. But the question still remains, do stem cells work? Do they help you? Well, we have used stem cells and we've been using them for a while for bone marrow transplantation for conditions such as leukemia and myeloma. It's very successful and we've been using it for quite a long time. But using it for myeloma and cancer of the blood is a very different story than using it in orthopedics. In orthopedics, research studies are trying to determine the safety and the efficacy of use in arthritis and back and neck degenerative conditions. Some clinics have offered these treatments and reported improvement in pain levels with decreased inflammation and some restoration of cartilage lining. But the treatment is still considered experimental and has not been FDA approved for any musculoskeletal condition. While there's promise, it's too early to know if there's a long-term benefit at this time. So the question is, do stem cells work for back pain? As stated above, no FDA-approved stem cell for back pain at this time. There are some ongoing studies. A few of them have been completed. There have been some reports of success, but much of the reporting has been on very small series with no long-term follow-up to assess long-term benefit. So what remains to discuss is, what are the controversies of using stem cells for back pain? Well, the first question we must understand is, what is the source of the back pain? Now, if we believe it's disc degeneration, then the use of the stem cell is trying to reverse or correct that degenerative process. At this point, it's still not clear that we really have a good handle on what is the pain generator in a degenerating disc. We know many people age with no significant back pain at all. Others, however, are incapacitated by minor degenerative findings. If we determine that disc degeneration is the cause, how do we attack the disc degeneration with the use of stem cells? We have to first determine what kind of cells we need to help this degenerative process. Do we need more cartilage lining? Do we need more cells to produce a protein called proteoglycan that actually imbibes or collects water? Do we need cells that improve the end plate and allows better disc nutrition? Do we create a stronger annulus or the cartilage on the outside of the disc to improve the disc? Those cells have to potentially repair or achieve these functions. But we still don't know if that's the proper way to make people better when they have disc degeneration. Their controversy still remained over what kind of cells can be used. Do we take it from your own body? Can we use cells that are donated from other people? If we take the cells, are the cells from your bone marrow better than the cells from your fat tissues? Can other cell lines, such as cells taken from umbilical cords of babies, does that also provide the same kind of differentiation properties that we think stem cells need to have? How do we trigger the stem cells to produce the right new cells? What is the right cell type that must be formed? For example, when you put stem cells in somebody's spine, should that cell then be triggered to produce a certain type
of cartilage cell or certain type of protein producing cell or certain type of collagen? Is age a factor? If you use stem cells from older people, do these stem cells still have the same potential to change and differentiate? Do transplanted cells stay alive? In the back and in the knee or in the hip, these joints and the discs are actually pretty hostile cell environments. Do these transplanted cells stay in the location of transplantation? How many cells are necessary to achieve a good result? We have to understand that there are also potential side effects that we still don't really understand. What are the side effects? When do they occur? How long do we need to follow these folks? There's a tremendous excitement for stem cells and biologic solutions for arthritis and back pain. Like any person, I truly hope stem cell therapies will prove beneficial for many conditions. But as a physician and a scientist, I have concerns that we still do not know the answers to many questions about the use of stem cells. More unbiased research needs to be done before we can fully answer the many questions about this evolving field. If you are considering the options of stem cells, make sure you do your homework. Understand the experimental nature of its use in orthopedic conditions and be prepared to pay for the costs, as these treatments are not yet approved for use by most payers. This is Dr. John Shim discussing stem cells. It's a very exciting concept, and at this time, I'm convinced that the more we learn, the more we realize there are more questions that need answering in this topic. Thank you for listening.